Okay, here it is, the remainder theorem is there. First of all, I am taking directly to the example, which will help you to understand more easily. Find the remainder when the first polynomial is divided by the second polynomial. So first polynomial will be written in the form of f of x is equals to x cube minus 5x square plus 2x minus 3. And the second one, which is x minus 1, will put it equals to 0 and get the value of x. And this value of x will be placed in this, just like we used to put the values in the functions. F of 1 we will be finding. And I am telling you here that no need to do anything manually. You will just place the values and then put it in the calculator and let me know what do you get the answer from there. 1 minus 5 plus 2 minus 3, since it is quite easy, so I can do it quickly. And minus 5 minus 3 is minus 8 and 1 plus 2 is 3. So we are left with minus 5. And the number here you will be left with, this is going to be your remainder. This theorem is considered as remainder theorem. I repeat the process that the first polynomial will put it at equals to f of x or p of x. And the second one will be putting equals to 0 to get the value of x. And this value of x will be placed in the first one. And after placing this number in the first one, whatever the answer you will be getting, this will be your remainder. Let's take another example. This was part A. I took it for you. And I'm taking now F part over here, let's say. It says F of X is equals to 2X cube plus 5X square minus 3X and plus 6. And the second polynomial which is given to us, which will be dividing it, 3X plus 1 equals to 0. So from there, if we get the value of x, this becomes minus 1 over 3. So let's place this value of x in this. 2 into minus 1 over 3 power 3 plus 5 into minus 1 over 3 power 2 minus 3 into minus 1 over 3 and plus 6. Now you'll put all of these values in the calculator and let me know what do you get from there. Please, anyone who can help me in this, place these values in the calculator once and let me know what do you get from there. Yes, bete, anyone who can give me the answer of this? What do you get from there? By taking LCM, I'm simplifying it. 27 into 9, how much comes? Anyone having calculator right in front of you, please quickly give me the answer.
And it's 256 divided by 27.
All together, 256? Divided by 27, this is 243 if I am not wrong then. So this is your remainder in this case. So I hope you are clear about that. Just by placing the second polynomial's value, this one, this one, this one, in the first one, and whatever the number you will be getting by placing it, just like we were placing in the functions, the final value we'll be getting, this is called the remainder, right? And if this remainder gives a value equals to zero, it means the expression first one is completely divided, because we know when something is completely divided, the remainder is going to be zero, right or not? Just like you see 27 divided by 9, we know 9 threes are 27 and the remainder becomes zero. When remainder becomes zero, it means this 27 number is completely divided by 9. So we may write that for this 20, if remainder is 0, 27 is divisible by 9, right? Do you get that? It is divisible. When something is completely divisible, remainder is always zero. So if the remainder, this answer, if you get it equals to zero, it means the first expression is completely divided by the second one. Or the statement could be written that the second polynomial is divisor of this. Am I clear? This one, it is dividend, to be divided. This is divisor, this is quotient, and this one is remainder. Any question till here, you may ask for it, beta. Anyone who needs to ask anything, please feel free to ask. Anyone confused? Please.
You can ask. Zero or negative, beta.
Okay, no problem. See here. Here you are getting some value over here, right? 256 over 27. Here you are getting remainder equals to minus 5. Remainder means there is something left. We could not completely divide it. Like, for example, if you see 22. Saf was there, I think, right?
Yes,
sir. Saf, if we divide 22 by 3, what will happen? 3 sevens are 21. What will be left?
7 over 1 by 3.
No. Just what is left? This one, right?
Mm-hmm.
This is your remainder. When something is left in place of remainder other than 0, it means 22 is not completely divisible by 3, right? So when it comes 0, just like this one, it means 27 is completely divisible by 9. So if you see somewhere, first expression is divisible by the second one, it means remainder is going to be 0 in that case, right? Do you get it?
Mm-hmm.
Now, okay, no problem. We'll be doing many examples regarding this. You don't need to memorize it. I would like you to go for B, D, and H only. Quickly, you can go through these, all of you. And then we will go for some more questions, which are actually the questions of the sort of the paper questions, you know. Right? So I'm waiting for your response so that if you get any help, if you need any help, you can ask for it. Please.